Hello and welcome to the Quincy Access Television Studios. I'm Mark Crosby. Welcome to In the Know, a program that looks at various programs, events that we feel you should be aware of. We'll bring all those to your attention right here during this particular program. Today, the topic is Wreaths Across America. And joining me to talk about this particular nationwide program is George Bouchard. He is the Graves Registration Officer here in the city of Quincy for the Quincy Veterans Services. And Christine Cugini. She is the location coordinator for Wreaths Across America. So welcome to you both.
Thank you.
Thank you.
What is Wreaths Across America? Who would like to take that
I would give
challenge?
That, I would give that to Christine to start you off.
Okay, Christine.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wreaths Across America is a nonprofit organization out of Maine. They started in 1992. In 2005, they went nationwide and became a nonprofit. They raise funds to lay wreaths at veterans' graves across the United States and Arlington National Cemetery. This year will be Quincy's first year participating in National Wreaths Across America Day.
And their mission is remember, honor, and teach.
Yes, remember our veterans that have passed, honor the ones that are serving today, and teach our children the importance of freedom.
So how did Quincy become involved?
Well, Christine and Paul Prefontaine notified our office about coming to Quincy this year. So we scheduled a meeting with them because we had some certain concerns about how the program runs and everything. So after sitting down with them, our concerns were laid to rest, let's just say. They explained to us everything they're going to be doing, how they're going to be doing, and how the whole program runs. So we had a tentative date to approve this, but we wanted to talk to Scotty Logan, the general foreman for the cemetery department, to make sure he's on board with this. After discussing things with him, everything was fine. We're all on board. We signed the proper paperwork and made Mount Wollaston one of the destinations for the Wreaths Across America. And I might add that we're really excited about it.
And this was announced back in August.
Yes. August, correct. August 13th, I believe it was. Yes.
Now this involves over 3,000 wreaths here in the city of Quincy.
Yes. Not so much in the city of Quincy, just at Mount Wollaston.
Okay.
We're looking at about...
But that's the only spot.
Yes, that's the only spot. And by doing Mount Wollaston this year, we're hoping to get the volunteers and the donations so we can expand next year to the other cemeteries. So we're looking at between 3 and 3,200 at Mount Wollaston alone. And this is not just the veterans' lot. It's the entire cemetery where there's a veteran buried.
Okay. Okay. And what are we looking for folks to do? I suppose two things. First, donate money for the wreaths, and second, help place the wreaths?
Yes. So the wreaths, you sponsor a wreath or one or more through the website, or you can contact George in the Veterans Office. And volunteering, I think, is most important. It's not a requirement that you sponsor a wreath. I think the more people involved will bring this city together, and it's just a very good community program.
Well, let's look at getting to some of that contact information.
Absolutely.
The website for Wreaths Across America
is www.wreathsacrossamerica.org.
And once someone goes onto that site, they can donate a wreath.
Yes.
They can make it specific to the city of Quincy.
Yes. So when you get to the website, you would see a sponsor box. Below that, you have two options. One is specific location, and the other is through a fundraising group. I ask that you go to the fundraising group to sponsor your wreath. And that will bring up a search bar, and you would type in Quincy there. The Robert I. Nickerson Post comes up, and that's where you would donate and fill out the form to sponsor a wreath.
And of course, George, the other option, if folks would like, they could simply call Veterans Services.
They could call me at Veterans Services at 617-376-1194 or 1192. Yes.
And when we talk about Wreaths Across America, there is actually a Wreaths Across America Day.
There is. It's December 15th, Saturday, this year. They generally have it on the second Saturday in December every year. So this year is Saturday, December 15th, and we hope to see everybody there.
And that day, during that day, there will be a ceremony that will start.
Yes, we're going to have a short ceremony with a couple of speeches. The mayor, we're going to ask the mayor to say a few words. And there's a proper way of doing it. My understanding is with the national anthem, and six active military members will lay wreaths in front. We're going to be doing it in front of the World War II podium, lay six wreaths there with active military to get it started, and then we'll go forward.
So it starts there, and then the other wreaths are laid?
Yes, correct. The volunteers will take them from the boxes, I believe. Yeah. The truck drops off, and we'll go through the whole cemetery.
So it's all done that day?
Oh, yeah.
So the wreaths will show up through from one of their trucks that volunteer as well to deliver wreaths throughout the United States. We'll get notified when they're here and when they can drop them off, and then we'll move them around the cemetery to make it, you know, easy access for the veterans that are further in.
That's why the volunteers are so important, because the more we have, the less time it's going to take.
Right, because we're looking at 3,200.
Yes, it's a lot. And believe me, I've been at that cemetery. It's a big cemetery. So we want to get all of the veterans' graves done. We don't want to come up short.
We don't.
So the donations are huge. And I might add that this is not just individual donations. This is companies, too. That's the bread and butter.
Well, talk about exactly your role, I guess, during these, once Quincy was a designated location, what you've been doing since.
What hasn't she been doing?
Well, maybe this should be an hour-long program then.
What I did is compile a list of companies throughout Quincy, small companies, larger companies, and sent a letter personalized, basically, about my feelings and in my passion of this day and how important it is. I did go last year, and I participated down in Arlington National Cemetery. I can't even explain to you the feeling I had leaving that day, and I brought it back and immediately knew that Quincy was the city to do this. So I wrote letters. I sent about 100, maybe more, letters out to all the companies that, you know, were listed that I could come up with. Mm-hmm. Suggestions from George and other, you know, everybody is on board. You know, my family is sending me, you know, make sure you write this person, make sure you mm-hmm. get the letter out to this person. So we're just starting. There were about three waves of letters, and it's slow, but we're hearing from people now, so it's really wonderful to know that people are reading the letters.
Well, you'll have this program, certainly, and of course, social media.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So on social media, I've posted on my own Facebook page, and then a lot of the Quincy everything, Quincy happenings, and I look to have everybody just share the information. If you see it, share it, and, you know, we'll get the word out, and hopefully we'll get, you know, the numbers that we need, both for volunteer and for donations to lay a wreath.
And once again, the donation is $15.
Yes, it's $15, but you can buy two for $30. And in that case, if you buy the two, you get a third one free.
Oh, really? Okay.
If you put on to the Robert I. Nickerson posts, yes, the third one is thrown in.
Okay. And once again, I would like to go over for
sure.
Folks, again, access to the website, what they need to do, and then, of course, if they do want to call the local veterans services, mm-hmm. they are, of course, invited to do so.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
So again, the website is www.wreathsacrossamerica.org. On the front page, you'll see a sponsor box. Below that will be two options. One is a specific location. The other one would be the specific fundraising group. We'd like you to click on the fundraising group, and in the search bar, you want to type in Quincy, and the Robert I. Nickerson post will come up. You click on that, and then you fill out the form to sponsor.
Or just call me. I might add.
If we could just go right ahead.
Yep. There is also a cleanup day. This is not one day.
Okay. Well, let me give out that number.
Sure.
617-376-1194.
Correct. Yes.
Now, proceed.
So January 12th would be the cleanup day. Also looking for volunteers.
Right, because we should mention these are going to be on the graves for a month.
For 1 month, correct. And I think you had scheduled January 12th to set it up, weather permitting. Who knows if it's going to be snow, heavy snow. But that's the cleanup day. We're looking for many volunteers for that day also to make it a short day to get it done. And I might add, I want to thank Scotty Logan for letting us do this because it is we thought we would have to clean it up until she assured me that they come back to clean up, which is fine.
And just talk, if you could, about the placement of the wreaths. There are gravestones, but then there are
headstones.
Markers.
Yes. Yes. Well, the markers in the veterans lot, they'd be laid on top of them, okay, which I think is going to look beautiful. And the private lots throughout the cemetery will be the headstones, and they'd be laid in front of the headstone. Correct.
Any other things that we didn't cover for this particular initiative that you would like to talk about?
Well, we do have her in the parade this year, getting information out to the public. So if you're coming to the Veterans Day parade, please pull Christine aside or myself and see if you can help us. And I want to make Quincy proud. The mayor's office, the city council and school committee have really stepped up in taking care of their veterans in this city, and I just hope the public does now.
And we should mention, too, that Quincy, Mount Wollaston specifically, is one of 1,400 participating locations.
Yes, correct. Throughout the United States, it's quite amazing to think that on Saturday, December 15th, the ceremony, the laying of the wreaths, this is going on across the nation. It's just a beautiful day. And I want everybody to just share on it and understand and just take part. It's beautiful.
No, I might add, on the 1,400, not all of them do the entire cemetery. Am I correct? Isn't there some?
There are a few that just do the ceremony only, but we chose to go for it.
Yes, the entire.
And do the laying of the wreaths with the ceremony involved.
Well, one thing about Quincy certainly is that it always remembers its veterans.
It does.
It absolutely does.
And these are the men and women who don the uniform that are no longer with us, and I think they deserve this.
And it's a great, I know this is in the mission statement, the teaching part, but certainly this is another teaching tool, clearly, for students.
I just think it's important for the kids to be able to actually thank a veteran.
Yes.
You know, we hope to have many veterans there as well. And it's important for the children today to give back.
I will brag about this, I guess, but I have a 14-year-old, so it's okay. I'm really bragging about him. It's really something that he's done. Whenever he sees a veteran, he always goes up and thanks them, which is
outstanding.
Outstanding, and it makes me proud that he realizes the importance of service.
You did a good job then.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
I might add that Christine is a veteran herself from the United States Navy.
Thank you. Thank you both for your service.
Thanks. Absolutely. Thank you.
Well, thank you for coming in and speaking about wreaths across America. We will certainly publicize this. We will get it running on both of our channels, as well as our Quincy Access YouTube channel, and our website, which is qatv.org.
Great.
So we will get multiple plays from this program. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you. With the effort.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Mark. Thanks.
And thank you at home for watching. You have been watching a program of Quincy Access Television. Please continue to watch QATV for more locally produced programming.